Hey everyone, in this session we are going to talk about one of the newly rolled out feature by Microsoft during this July 2020 update, which is Azure Map Visual in Power BI. Myself Dhruvin Shah, and in this session we are going to discuss about Azure Map Visualization. So before we get started, let me show you what we are going to cover during this session. First, we will start with the introduction part of Azure Map Visualization. After that, we are going to discuss about some of the limitations of Azure Map Visual, and then we are going to move with the layers in Azure Map Visualization. Once we discuss the layers, there are two types of layer: data rendering layer and external layer. We will be deep dive into these two types of layer in for Azure Map Visual. After that, we will go with the real life use cases and scenario. In Azure Map, there are five types of layer. We are going to talk about each of the layer with real life sample, real life examples. So these five layers are bubble layer, bar chart layer, reference layer, tile layer, and traffic layer. So we are going to discuss about each individual layer in the detail. The first question arises in our mind that why Azure Map Visual? The answer is here. As we all know that most of the time 80% of our business data have a location context, and the Azure Map Visual for Power BI provides a rich set of data visualization for spatial data on top of the map. So the Azure Map Visual can be used to gain insight into how the location context relates to and influences our business data. So this is how the Azure Map Visual is useful for our business data. Now, the question is how this Azure Map is working. The Azure Map Visual connects to the cloud service hosted in the Azure to retrieve the location data such as map images and coordinates that we are going to create the map visualization. So it is something which is passes in form of latitude, longitude, and location. And this process is called geocoding. So this was a theoretical concept. Let me explain you this in a very simple term. It is something whenever we add latitude or longitude on our Azure map, what it will do is it will call the cloud service hosted in the Azure, and it will retrieve the location data such as map images and the coordinates that are used to create the map, right? So this is how the Azure Map Visualization is working. Now, let me talk about some of the consideration or limitations that we need to keep in our mind. So the first limitation is it is not available for publish to web and Power BI embedded. Now, at this moment, it is not supporting China and South Korea region. Rest of the countries and regions are supported. At this moment, this visual supports up to 30,000 data points on the map. The initial preview of this visual only supports latitude or longitude value in the decimal degrees. In future, update will add to support the addresses and location string. So it is simple and straightforward and easy to understand. So we need to consider these limitations before we move further, right? Now, let me talk about the different available layers for the Azure Maps. So whenever you add the Azure Maps, we have two types of different layer. First is data rendering layer and external layers. Now, what is data rendering layer? There are two types of data rendering layer: bubble layer and bar chart layer. And under external layer, we have three different layers: reference layer, tile layer, and traffic layer. So now we are going to talk about each individual layers in detail during this session. So stay connected with me throughout the entire session. Now, before we move further, let me give you the overall idea about each of the individual layer for the map visualization. So whenever we go for the demo part, you will not have any confusion. So first of all, let me talk about the bubble layer. As you can see that the bubble layer is something which renders a point as scaled circle on top of the map like this. So this is the map, and it renders a scaled circle on the map, right? So this is called a bubble layer. Now, second one is bar chart layer. So what do we mean by bar chart? So basically it will render 3D bars on the map like this. So let's say Sometimes there is a situation where we need to show specific sales data for specific region in a form of a bar. So at that time, this bar chart layer will be very useful to us, right? Now, the third layer is reference layer. So basically, this reference layer overlay an uploaded GeoJSON file on the top of the map. So it is something that is the additional layer on the top of the map. So let's say if you wish to add some specific reference layer on your map, at that time you can use this layer. Tile layer, it is also the additional layer. So basically it will overlay a custom tile on the top of the map. So let's say with respect to sales, you want to show the weather data from your third party API, at that time this type of layer will very helpful. And don't worry, I am going to explain each individual layer later on this session. And at last, the fifth layer is traffic layer. So how does it helpful? So it will show the real-time traffic information on the top of the map. So this is how the traffic layer will help to us. So here we have discussed all the basic information about the Azure map. Now let's go with the demo part and check each individual layer in detail with the help of example. So let's get started with the first layer, which is bubble layer. First of all, let me talk about what is bubble layer. As we all know that bubble layer is something which renders the points as scaled circle on the top of the map. So now let me go to the Power BI and let's get started how we can create bubble layer for the Azure map visualization. So let me switch to the Power BI. This is my Power BI desktop. We all know that this Azure map visualization is something which is the preview feature. We need to enable that from the desktop setting. First of all, make sure that your Power BI desktop has been updated to the latest version of July 2020. After that, from File, go to the Options and Setting, click on Options. Once you click on Option, it will open one pop-up. From that pop-up, we need to select the preview features. From preview feature, make sure that you have enabled this Azure map visualization. Now, once you click on Select, click on OK, and after that, just close your Power BI desktop and reopen the desktop to see the reflection. Once you enable this feature, one of the visualization has been added under Visualization Pane. As you can see that I enabled this feature, so this Azure map visualization is available over here. So just add this visualization on your page. Once you add this visualization on your page, it will show this type of disclaimer for you, right? Now let me show you my data and my example. I have taken an example of COVID-19 cases. So basically, I have latitude longitude information about the COVID cases by the country, right? So now let me first add few fields to set the map visualization over here, right? For that, what we need to do here is we need to add latitude, longitude, legend, size and tooltip, right? So first thing is that let's add latitude and longitude under this Azure map visualization. So I added the latitude or longitude value over here. One important tip I want to share with you here. Let's say for an example, if you have filled for latitude or longitude and if it is not detected as a map directly, what you need to do here is just select your column and go to the column tools property. From data category, define that as latitude, and same way for longitude, define that as longitude. So this is the best practice that we can follow, right? Now in legend, let's add country as a legend, and under size you can set let's say we can set confirmed cases over here. So let's add confirmed value over here. So it will show us the confirmed cases for COVID-19. As you can see that these are the scaled circle. So the size of the circle defines the number of cases are more in that particular region. So let's say this is the China region where the confirmed cases are more for that particular day, right? So this is how we can configure the Azure map properties. Hope this is clear for you now so far. So now let me talk about our first layer, that is bubble layer. But before we do that, we need to consider few map properties over here. So first of all, expand your map setting. In map setting, we have the different property. So the first property is auto zoom property. Now what is auto zoom and how it is useful to us? Auto zoom is something which automatically zoom the map when the data loaded through the filled pane section. So whenever we zoom, it will set map composition automatically over here. So this is the first property. What if you turn off? If you turn off the map property, auto zoom property, five more properties we need to set. First is zoom level. So it is the number between 0 to 22 we need to set. Center latitude and center longitude value we need to set. Heading value we need to set. So what is heading value? So heading is the default orientation of the map in degrees. So it is in between 0 to 360 degree. So 0 is north, 90 is east, 180 is south, and 270 is west. So we need to set proper heading over here. And same with pitch. So the default tilt of the map in the degree is between 0 to 60 degree. 0 is straightforward down to the map. So you can set in between 0 to 60 for the pitch, right? So let's not auto zoom as off. Let's turn it on. So it will zoom the map automatically. Now the second thing is world wrap. World wrap is something which allows the user to pan the map horizontally infinitely. So you can see that I am panning my map visual horizontally and it is the infinite. Now if I turn off world map, what it will do is you can see that only this specific square box has been shown to the map over here. So world wrap is doing something like that. Now style picker. So style picker is something which is this one. You can choose the different style for your map. These are the different style option available. You can hover and check each individual name over here. Then there is a property navigation control. So here you can see the different navigation control available, which is zoom in, zoom out, pitch, and rotation. So based on your requirement, if you do not want the end users to allow navigation, you can just turn it off, right? Same is for style picker as well. You can turn it off using this option, right? Now at last we have the map style. So you can set the map style like this. These are the different available map style. So you can set based on your requirement, right? So this is how the basic map setting works. This will be common for all the visualization. It will be common for all the layers. So I'm not going to explain this thing in detail in the other sessions. So consider this setting property over here itself, right? So we have talked about the map setting and map view settings over here. Now coming towards our layer, that is bubble layer. Here there are different properties that we need to configure. Let me consider and start with the easiest one. Then we will go with the complex one, right? So the first property is minimum size and maximum size. So it is something which defines the size of the bubble over here. So let's say if we increase the size of the bubble, it will set the minimum size like that. Same way we can set the maximum size as well. Now there is a method for size scaling. In size scaling, there are three types of algorithm used: linear, logarithm, and cubic bezier. By default, linear scaling method has been set, but you can choose the logarithm method as well. So once you select the logarithm method, we need to provide the log scale over here. Log scale is something which is applied when we calculating the size of the bubble, right? So we just need to define the log scale. So let's just define log scale as it. So it will used when the size of the bubble is being defined, right? And at last, cubic bezier method. So this is also the another interesting method. Like here, if we select cubic bezier, we need to provide the four different values, two x parameter and two y parameter. x1 x2 y1 y2. So basically it is a scaling method, it is a size scaling method. So basically it is based on the curvature. So how can you easily define this curvature? So let me show you that thing. Let me explain you with the one of the side. So this is the cubicbezier.com website. So here you will find the different type of curvature. So based on your requirement or value, honestly I am not having much idea on it, but let me show you that thing. So basically the minimum value for cubic bezier parameter is 0 and maximum value is 1, and it spreads the value, it defines the size based on the cubic bezier algorithm. So basically if we set, let's say, this type of curvature, we are getting this value x1 x2 y1 y2. So basically we just need to put that value over here and it will set our size of the bubble based on this size scaling method. So I'm not going to much deep dive into cubic bezier. If you wish to have a search on the cubic bezier, you can go to Google and go for that. You will be getting so much mathematical calculations over there. I'm setting this as linear at this moment. Now let me move over to the another property, fill transparency. So we can define the bubble fill transparency using this option. High contrast outline. So let's say if we want to show outline around the bubble, we can use this property. Outline transparency we can define using this one. Outline width is something which we can define using this property, outline width. Blur property, we can define the blur property. So once we select the blur property, what it will do is it will blur our border, and you can see the effect into the bubble like this. So this is blur property. Now let's talk about the pitch alignment. By default we have viewport pitch alignment set, we have another pitch alignment as map as well. So let me talk about what is pitch alignment. So let's say here you can see that we have increase or decrease pitch. So you can see that this is our pitch that we have set. So whenever we have selected a viewport, we can see these bubbles have been added on the edges of the map. Now let's say if I select map, what will happen? When we select the map, bubbles are rendered on the flat surface of the map. So this is something which is the basic difference between viewport and pitch. In viewport, the bubbles are on the edges, or in the map, it is on the flat surface of the map. Zoom scale, we can define the zoom scale using this property. Minimum zoom level and maximum zoom level we can define over here, and same way layer position. So let's say there are three types of layer position: above layer labels, below labels and below roads. So let's say by default below labels has been set. Now what if we set above labels, what will happen? So let me zoom something. My bubble layer position is above labels. Now if we select below label, what will happen is it will hide this bubble under the label, and if we select below roads, it will be below the road, right? So it is recommended to have it above labels, right? Like this. So hope this is clear for you. Now this is how we can configure the bubble layer in the Azure Map Visual. All right, now let me talk about some general layer settings. So for this map we can define five different properties: unselected transparency, show zeros, show negatives, minimum value and maximum data value. We need to configure five different properties. So let's say what are these properties. Unselected transparency, so whenever we select any of the bubble over here, what is the value for the other bubbles transparency, we can set using this option. Simple. Show zeros, if we do not want to show any zero value, zero size value on the map, we can turn it off using this option, right? Show negatives, if we do not want to show any negative size value, then we can turn it off using this option. Minimum and maximum data value, so it represents the minimum value of the input data to scale against, and maximum data value to scale against. So we can define these things over here. So these are the general layer setting, right? So this will be common for all the layers, map settings and general layer settings. We have talked about this in this session. So for the other layers, we will be skipping this thing. Now let's talk about the bar chart layer over here. So let me open my Power BI desktop. Now here I have taken an example for one of the car selling company, which is selling the car for different state. So first of all, let's add that thing to the map. So let me add Azure map from here. Now here we need to add latitude and longitude. So let's select latitude and longitude over here. So I have added those two columns. Now under size we need to set number of cars sold, and let's define country as legend over here. So this will show this type of graph to us, right? So this is how we have configured the chart. By default it is showing the bubble chart to us, but we don't want to see bubble chart. We want to see another layer, that is the bar chart layer. For that, what we need to do here is we just need to turn off this bubble and we just need to turn on this bar chart layer over here. So as you can see here, the bar chart is showing like this. It is showing like 3D chart, right? Now let's talk about its different configuration properties over here. So the first thing is that map settings, and so the first setting is map settings. It is same as bubble chart. Same way, general layer setting will also be same as the bubble chart. So we are not going to talk on that. We will only focus on bar chart property. Here the first property is bar shape. You can set bar shape as box or as cylinder. So you can see that at this moment it is looking like cylinder. Now if we want to convert that box, it will look like this. Now the second property is height property. How long you wish to have your bar height. So you can change the height property using this option. Scale height on zoom. So this will specify if the width of the bar should scale relative to the zoom level. So you can choose turn it on or off using this option. Transparency of bar can be changed using this property. Minimum and maximum zoom level same as the previous layer we can set. And layer position is also same, below, above or below roads. So let's say for an example, let's consider this one. Let's set below label. So it will set our bar below label. Above label, which means that bar will hide some of the text of your label, right? So you can set the different layer position over here. So this is how we can configure our bar chart over here, right? Hope this is clear for you now. Now let me talk about the another third layer of the Azure map, which is the reference layer. So now let's get started with that one. So this reference layer and tile layer are the external layer which can be added on the top of the data layer. So now what is reference layer? Reference layer is something which overlay and uploaded GeoJSON file on the top of the map. Now what do we mean by that? Let me explain you with the help of example. So this is my Power BI map visualization and I added the Azure map visual over here. So I already explained here about the bubble and bar chart visualization. So here I already added one bubble chart. Now let me talk about the external layer on the top of the map. So first let's talk about the reference layer. So what is reference layer? It will allow us to add additional reference layer on the top of the map, right? We can upload any JSON file or .geojson file using this option. So click on add local file. I already have one JSON file over here. So once we add our JSON file, what it will do is, based on the data, it will load the specific value to our map. So here I have the US region's boundary information, and it has added those boundaries on the top of our map like this, right? So how this file will look like? So this is the GeoJSON file. Don't worry, I am going to provide this file in the comment section. I have downloaded it from official Microsoft GitHub account, so I will share this link over here. So you can download any geocode.json file using this option. So to prepare the geocode.json file is also something which is syntaxually, right? So first of all, its type is feature, and in properties we can set the different properties like this. And in geometry, we need to provide its geometric information over here. So this is the geometric tag, and here the different coordinates, latitude, longitude, has been provided, right? So this is how this boundary JSON will look like, right? And this is how we have added one reference layer on the top of the map, right? You can choose the reference layer data based on your requirement, right? Now let me talk about another thing, which is tile layer. Now what do we mean by this tile layer? If we expand this tile layer, we will be having different properties of URL, tile size, north, south, east and west bound, transparency, TMS, minimum maximum zoom and layer position. So it is a similar like external reference layer. So let's say for an example, with this particular thing, let's say for an example, let me remove this reference layer over here and let me go to the tile layer. Let's say for an example, with the sales data, you want to show some weather information using Azure services. So at that time, what you need to do here is, you need to provide any of the URL over here, and based on the URL, it will show the weather information inside the map itself. So let me show this with one of the examples over here. Let's say here we have one URL of Azure Radar service. I don't have subscription key, I have this type of URL where I have set the different parameters, and based on that it will show weather information over here. It will not show anything to me over here because I don't have subscription key, and I will just explain you this with the help of example. So here you need to select the different property. First is URL. So you need to provide formatted URL. Tile size. Tile size means integer value that specify both width and height dimension of the tiles. You need to set it over. North, south, east and west bound. So basically northern latitude, southern latitude, eastern latitude and western longitude we need to set over here. Then transparency. Transparency of tile layer we need to set here. East TMS. East TMS is tile map service, a specification that reserves the Y coordinate for the axis of the tile layer. Minimum maximum zoom, we know that, and layer position will same as the other layers, right? So these are the different configuration properties, right? So this is how the tile layer will work, right? Hope this is clear for you now. Now let's move over to the next layer, that is the traffic layer. Now what is traffic layer? So basically it will overlay real-time traffic information on the top of the map. So now let me explain you with the help of the example. So this is my map visualization. You know that how did I configure this bubble chart for Azure map. Now let me add one live traffic over here on the top of the map. For that, what we need to do here is, we just need to go to this format property, then we have an option traffic layer. We just need to turn it on. So once we turn it on, we have two things: show incidents and traffic control. So whenever you turn the traffic layer, it will show real-time traffic on the map. So let's wait for a moment. And here it is. You can see different traffic layer information on the Azure map. It is showing the live traffic over here. You can see different symbols has been added over here as well, right? It has two options: show incidents or traffic control. Show incidents specify if traffic incidents such as road closure or construction should be displayed on the map. So you can see that here the construction is going on. So it is showing these incidents over here. There is a traffic jam. So it is showing this type of indication to us like this, right? Now traffic control. So once we click on it, it will show this traffic control option to us. So when we click on that, it will show or hide traffic based on our selection, right? If you want to provide this selection to your end user, you can turn it on, otherwise you can turn it off. So basically traffic layer only has two different properties, right? So hope this is clear for you now. And we have checked all the important property of Azure Map Visualization. If you have any question, you can add your questions in the comment section, or you can email us at dhruvinsha16@gmail.com. If you are for the first time to my channel, make sure you hit subscribe and press the bell notification to never miss any updates from my channel. Stay connected with me on Facebook, LinkedIn, Twitter and WhatsApp. If you wish to receive the daily notification from my channel, click on this link. It will be redirecting you to this form. Fill the form and you will be receiving daily notification on your WhatsApp number. Stay connected with me. Have a great day. Goodbye.